Hello, you're welcome. This is Don Wifey Tech, and I'm here basically to show us and take us on a journey on how to use hash cards under the Satoshi mining app. Quick one, very quickly, before I go into this teaching or this tutorial, I'd like you to subscribe to our account, Don Wifey Tech, just below the post, the video. Click the subscription button to get more, and equally click the bell notification especially to get more videos on how to use our tech and our tech videos and all of that. Without wasting too much time, let's go into the study of hashcards. Now basically, hashcards are very, very simple. The idea of hashcards is basically to increase the rate of your mining, and every hashcard that you add to yourself increases what we call my hash, your hash. The hash increases the rate of mining and the speed of mining. Okay, so if you're working at this level of speed, maybe 2, 4, you can actually go from 2 to 8 as the rate of mining. Okay, very quickly now, so I'll take us quickly. Normally, if you're a newbie, I mean a newcomer into the Satoshi mining business, most times they will give you all the cards. You'll see a beetle card, you'll see an ant card, you'll see a rock card, you see all the cards stated out for you. But once you begin to use and use and use and use, and you exhausted all your cards, you get to see very few of those cards. So I'll take you into the hash card. So you click the hash card, and then it opens up, and then you can see that they're only giving an ant card. You know, if I decide not to use this card, and maybe tomorrow comes, they will add another card, increases to 2 cards. If I don't use it again next day, it doesn't keep increasing. But basically, because I want to increase my hash rate, I have to keep using my cards. Do we understand? So it's very quickly now. So I was given a hash, I was given an ant card. Normally, like I said, they'll give a B2 card, give an ant card. A B2 card comes with a 1k hash, an ant card comes with a 2k hash. I think either of a spider or a rock card comes with a 3k and a 4k respectively hash, and then a fifth card is the formation card. All right, the fifth card is the formation card. All right, so basically, how do we use these cards? I said the basic idea of the gift card, especially card, is to increase your hash and the speed of mining, and equally the rate of income that comes to you by reason of the mining. Okay, so basically, this is what you do. You either initiate a transaction or you join a transaction. It's very simple. So basically, in this case, so if somebody comes on, or maybe on a WhatsApp group of Satoshi miners, and then somebody pastes and says, maybe a spider card, please join. What you do is you come here, you copy that code, you come to join, and then you paste whatever code that there is, and then you click confirm, and it goes in. Okay, it goes in, and then it's submitted, and then you see a stream of people waiting for exchange. By the time that whole stream is completed, everybody, you can now execute the exchange. But now, in the case where you have to, you are the one who is initiating a transaction, that means you want people to come to join you in the transaction, you click initiate. Now, before we click, now you can see that there's 2 people, there's 3 people, there's 4 people, there's 5 people. So what he's saying is that, like the rule says, please select the number of people to exchange. So if you click 2 people, it means that you only want 2 people to join you in the exchange. If you click 3 people, you only want 3 people to join in the exchange. That means you only want 3 people to join. So those who are in need of a spider card will copy my code and come to spider card and paste the code and join. They'll click join and paste it there, and then they will get the reward of the hash. Okay, so let's take a step back again one more time. Now if you go back, you can see that the hash has a rate of 5%, and the hash card is a 2k hash card. All right, now let's go through some of the rules. One of the reasons why a lot of people don't succeed in Satoshi mining is that they don't read a lot, and it doesn't help us that way. Now let's read some very important rules here. It says you can start a hash card exchange and invite other miners to join. So if you click initiate, it means you are starting a hash card and you want other people to join. You can also join the hash card exchange initiated by other miners to increase your hash. All right, so hash card calculation, hash card, add up all the hash card rates. The more the number of exchanges, the greater the rate increase your hash. Okay, the more the number of exchanges, the greater. So if for example everybody who, because I see a lot of people get into some situations, now I'm going to do something. Let me, before I see this thought, click initiate, and then maybe I normally would advise people use 5 people, because like I said, like the rule says, the more the people that exchange, the more people that are able to exchange your code with, the more your hash increases. So I click 5 people and then I click initiate. Okay, hash card exchange initiated successfully, and you click close and it takes you out. Now you are this first person, you are the initiator. Okay, you are the initiator. All right, and then 4 people are going to be expecting to initiate. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll copy the code. All right, and then I'll go to my WhatsApp group, you know, where I have the Satoshi mining. So I click it open, and then I say paste, and then I send it to the group. This is an ant card, right? And then it goes, and then I now put a footnote under, and I say ant card. I say ant card. And card, please join now. Okay, and then I paste it. Okay, we can see that I paste it. So a lot of folks will begin to see it, and when they see it, they'll copy it. And then now if you look at this chart, you can see that a couple of persons have pasted codes, pasted hash cards here for people to join. All right, so let's go back to our Satoshi mining app, and then people begin to join. So what you are seeing, waiting to join. Now let's note, this number one initiator is me. I'm the initiator, so I'll take one of the spots, of the one of the 5 spots. You remember you clicked 5, so I'll take the first spot. The remaining 2, 3, 4, 5 are going to be filled by members who need an ant card. Who need an ant card. Now this is going to lead me to the next point I'm about to make. Now there are some people who might not have an ant card, but because they are desperate to exchange a card, what they do is that they go and they will copy the code that I just pasted now, and then maybe they might be information card. An information card carries a 5k hash, and they will come to me and join. Chances are that because you joined an ant card, you will not get the value of your 4k or your 5k formation card. You will be getting the 2k because you entered a card that is not yours. Do you understand? You entered a card that is not yours. So normally I would advise, go in ant card for ant card, b2 for b2, spider for spider, formation for formation, rock for rock. Don't do anti-clockwise. A lot of folks trying to do that, and then they don't have a good increase. All right, and then if you're joining somebody, the person equally wants like for example, if you're joining my ant card now, I would want an ant card because at the end of the day I want to combine all my rates together so that I can get a good quantum and increase my hash very well. Because I'm a spider card, and then out of my spider, and I pick 5 slots, 5 persons to join me, I'm the first initiator. The remaining 4, maybe out of the 4, a spider card thing carries about 4k hash, and then I need more 4k hash people under me. If a B2 card person now comes and joins my card, he will reduce the rate of my hash, the increase of my hash. My hash card is supposed to carry a 4k increase, but because I have a B2 person who is carrying about 1k inside my combination, it's going to affect the rate of my increase of my hash of that particular card. Okay, and you don't want that. So basically, be patient to get into a card that is yours. Like I said, ant for ant, beetle for beetle, spider for spider, formation for formation, rock for rock. And let's not dabble into other people's cards and thereby reducing the rate of increase that they can have by beating the right card. Please, let's take note of that. It's very, very important. So let's see if people have joined. So I'm going to get back to my mining and then I'll click card. Okay? Okay, nobody has joined, but very soon some folks will join. All right? So with time, this thing, you will see somebody's email address there and then you'll see 2.10k hash, like that, like that, like that. If you checked before, this the rate of increase, when I distributed the card, it was written hash 2k and then the rate was 10k. The rate was 10k, so they added 2k plus 10k and that's what you have, 2.10k. That's why it's 2.10k. so it's important that I have every ant card person joining this, so that by the time they all join, I have a formidable thing figure that can increase this hash. It's very, very, very important. So from time to time, always begin to check your hash card. You know, if you come back, like now, if I check now, you know, and I go back to click hash card, and I don't see that people have not filled, you see, it's still showing me waiting to join. If I don't see that people have joined, I can still go back to the platform and paste again and say, hand card, please join now. Hand card, please join now. Something like that. And then I post it again and then wait for some time again and go and check again. By the time 2, 3, 4, 5 slots have been filled up, this place where you see a cancel exchange will now no longer be cancel exchange. What will be written there will be execute exchange. It means that your card is complete and they want you to execute. So that is for the person who is initiating an exchange. So you go there and you click exchange, execute rather, execute exchange. Now when you execute the exchange, it's not tell you confirm. To confirm, as soon as you execute that exchange, your hash would increase. Do we understand? Your hash would increase. But now if you are joining somebody's card, it's always different. You just see cancel exchange alone, but you cannot execute the exchange. Now, so if in the case of joining somebody and maybe it happens that the person's slot, the whole 5 slots is filled up, what you can do is you can go to back to that platform and say, so and so person, please, can you execute your exchange? The card is full, something like that. The person sees it, you tag the person on your WhatsApp, and then the person sees the information and goes to execute, because some people get to forget and they don't execute exchange. You can now go back and execute. The person goes there and execute that exchange so that everybody gets their due on the card. It's that simple. So same thing you do for your aunt card, your spider card, your beetle card, and all of those cards, you understand? And so basically that's how you use your hash card. The purpose of using the hash card is to increase your hash rate, and your hash rate in turn increases the rate of mining. So this is how far we can go. I don't want to belabor this topic. It's how far we can go. If you desire to join a Satoshi mining group, below this video is the link to the group. You can click it and join for more enlightenment and for you to be able to have access to mine, you know, as much as exchange cards, especially gift cards. Not gift cards, especially hash cards, you know. And then if you're new to this business, you can click the link below to get recruited under this under my link. And once you click the link, automatically you'll be registered, and then you can I'll leave my phone number there. You can chat me up to lead you on the process on how to fully execute your mining process. Thank you very much, and I hope this helps you. Thank you.